Perfect. Good. Okay. Yep. And you're gonna start all the way down. And actually, maybe I'll grab those weights so that they're gonna be, yeah, so we don't have to get back up again. Good. Okay. Palms out to the side now. Or at least feel comfortable. Yep. Eyes closed. Okay, I'm not sure if you know who David Goggins is, right? He's this like Navy SEAL who has just become like a crazy internet physical, activity inspiration motivator. And he says that like no matter how much you change, no matter how much you improve, right, it's not permanent. And this kind of struck me at the beginning of the year. And he says that in order to like keep growing, keep improving, there has to be three things. One, there's got to be some resistance. There's actually got to be some like mental thing, like, all right, this is going to be a little bit challenging. Number two, it needs to be a daily practice. And so it's not like yoga conditioning has to be your daily practice, but you daily have to come against resistance. And then number three is that you just do it. Okay. So that's kind of what I want to focus on here as you take a big inhale. And then exhale, lift your hips up, like into a bridge pose here, Allie, but not the one that's like way up in the chest, more of a one where you feel like you're posteriorly tucking your pelvis a little bit more. I find that it's more like a straight line from my knees to my hips to my shoulders. And when I really posteriorly tuck, I feel the hamstring kind of glute connection around the sitting bone. Okay. And then lower that back down. And then just make sure that we're going to keep the weight on the inner heels. Again, come up like that. Press the pubic bone up towards the ceiling. And if you want to close your eyes, now spread your palms open wide, stretch through your fingers. Inhale. Take your time and then exhale. Make a little fist, just kind of gently curling the fingers in. And I want you to tune into this kind of like expansion as you inhale. And the contraction as you exhale. Put an imaginary block between your knees and take two more, focusing on linking the breath with the movement. Fingers spread, chest spreads, exhale. You kind of contract in, maybe pulling into the core, pulling into the glutes a little bit more, this kind of natural changing, this expanding. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Put your hips down. Grab your weight. Okay. Elbows out wide, palms turned forward. Since your weights for you are kind of, I actually think they're pretty light, I'm gonna want you to lift your hips back up and just get a little bit more challenged. And then here you're gonna start some chest presses. Okay, so letting the short ends of the weight come together, and we don't wanna let our elbows really touch or rest on the floor. So when my weight is lighter, what I really focus on is like time under tension, and that both I'm kind of resisting as I'm coming down and when I come up. And then that final little thing is when you come up, if I lock my elbows, it's actually like a little break. So I kind of keep my elbows like micro bent. So I'm constantly kind of time under tension. And then remember the kind of like opening and closing of the hands and kind of feel that like opening of the chest and the squeezing in of the pectoral muscles. And you're going to go for five, four, three. Try to make it a little bit total body thing. Focus on the hips. Two and one. Okay, hips down. Now bring the elbows in close to the side body. Palms face one another. Take your arms all the way straight up. Now you have to keep a little bend in your elbows, okay? And then these are chest flies. So with straighter arms, take it all the way out to the side. And then when you feel right that you can kind of really like push up into the weight, hold it there for a pause, and then squeeze back up. Okay, so I like to take it out on these, pause at the extension, and then squeeze back in. Okay, so depending on how heavy the weights are, you might feel even the muscles on your upper back start to work as you squeeze in, and then get that pulsation. You inhale open and exhale close in. And count it out for your last. Five. Four. These are ones that I kind of do like a one count to open, a one count to hold, and a one count to pull it back in. Three. So it's really at the openness there that I keep the time under tension. Two. And you're going to go ahead and take one more. Pull the weight out a little bit. And then bring that back up to center. Okay, arms are straight now. Keep your elbows completely stacked over your shoulders. And then bend your elbows. Bring the short ends of the weights down next to your shoulders and start some tricep extension. So palms are facing towards one another. Good. So this is one of those ones that I would love it if someone was holding my elbows and keeping them from moving forward and actually really forcing me to just kind of go straight back. Okay, so see where you come across some resistance. Commit to it and just follow through with it as you go for five, four, three, trying to not lock the elbows. Two and one. Good. We're going to do one more set from the palms forward, elbows out wide. Yep. And chest presses here. So now, if for any chance you wanted to go like a little bit faster because your weights are light, making sure that you're pushing your low back down into the mat. Good. As you go for your last. Five, four, three, a little bit burning it out. Two, one. Good. Arms up. Turn the palms towards one another. Micro bend the elbows. Squeeze between the shoulder blades. Maybe get a little rhomboid and start the chest fly. Yep. And maybe at that faster pace, just controlling when you go five. Four, three. I focus on the pectoral muscles. Some people even press the weights into each other at the top to make sure that the pectoral squeeze. And then on that last one, arms go up, elbows over your shoulders, and start your tricep extensions. Okay. So last five, four. Three, two, one. Okay. Both arms up, holding there, lift the shins up away from the floor, and then kind of like a dead bug here, Allie, when the left arm goes back, the right leg extends, arm up overhead. And then the thing that we want to be careful of is that we go at a pace so we can push our low back down and then draw back to center. And then continue to switch here back and forth. Changing out arm and leg. Yep. And then my tendency is to always let my knees pull a little bit forward. I have to really kind of challenge myself to keep my knees over my hips. Good. As you pull in and then count it out for five, sideways lying down, four. Three, two, one. Okay, come back to center. Extend left arm back, right leg forward. Hold five, four, Three, two, kind of punch back through that left arm. Pull back up to center so you can feel that total body connection. And then last one, right arm back, left leg forward, side waistline, low back down. I'm kind of like through the body from my right hand, right shoulder, through my transverse abdominis to the left hip, left knee, left toes, stretching forward as you come all the way up. Good. Here. And then step your feet down into the mat, release one weight, grab the short ends of your weight, take your arms up overhead, biceps next to your ears. And then as you keep your feet glued, come all the way up to seated. Good. And then roll it back down. Inhale. Peel the spine up off the mat. Exhale. Yep. And five. Perfect. Looking for the tops of your sitting bones. Three. Hey, so it is easy, right? To kind of use the weight as momentum for your last two. I'm gonna kind of really challenge myself to go, but just a little bit slower. Because what this does, Ellie, is it changes kind of where your center of gravity is, and maybe it works some different muscles. Because you're going to come all the way down, grab your double weight. Palms face one another, straighten your legs. Okay, I flex my feet, elbows are in against the side body. You're gonna do kind of like a reverse chaturanga, press that up. So it's almost like a plank. Bend the elbows. Good. And then as you hold here, come all the way up to seated, elbows out wide into a shoulder press. Good. Elbows back in. And lower all the way down. Think back to your chaturanga, push to plank, elbows in, sit up, elbows wide, shoulder press. Good. So I kind of inhale down, exhale up, come to seated, and there you go. Yep, continue, count out three, four more rounds. Maybe you have to resist as you lower slow. If it's easy, dig down through the heels. Three. Good. Lower. Press. I try to press into my heels so I feel my hamstrings a little bit. Two. Right through the top of the shoulders. Heels are down. Last one. Push up. Draw in. Come all the way to seated. And extend the arms up. Good. Weights can go off to the side here for a moment. Cross your hands at your chest. Lower all the way down. Okay, keep your fingertips at your shoulders. Come all the way up, keeping your fingertips at your shoulders, not using your hands. Hands go back behind you, fingertips turn out, and take a Parvottanasana here. Feeling your hamstrings, your calf muscles, maybe ensuring getting the roots of your big toe mounds down into the mat, and then hips down, cross your arms and lower. Inhale, touch shoulders and sit back up, plant hands and Parvottanasana, little pause, squeeze between the shoulder blades and your last. Inhale down, exhale up for three. Yep, squeezing the muscles on the back body. Right, we kind of ignore that. Sitting up to rise. Big toe mounds down, calves, hamstrings, glutes, muscles of the low back. Two. And then you have your last one. Curl it down. Inhale. Keep the hands glued so we don't cheat. Good. And then hands back. And lift all the way up. Parvottanasana. Good. Bend your knees. Step your feet into the mat. Grab your weight. Good. Keep it at your chest. Float your feet and Russian twist here. Trying to tap as much as you can at the back of your mat. Now, I use the bottom hand to kind of push it up. So it's like when I'm twisting right, I press my right hand up. Good. Okay. Five, four, three, two, one, through center. Put your feet down. Inhale, arms up. Hands at your heart center. Squeeze knees. left elbow, outside edge of right knee. That same kind of concept that the backhand, the back elbow is using to kind of help push and draw you deeper into the twist. I always think in this pose, if I was sitting on a strap, I wouldn't let my left sitting bone pull forward. I'm going to stay very narrowed here. Inhale, exhale, back through center, grab your weight. Final one here at the chest. Lift the shins to parallel and start on your right side. Doesn't matter, actually. And then just continue here. Okay. And I can't remember if you were in the class when I said, like, at the gym, they're always yelling at me because I never twist back deep enough. I kind of just always tap it at my hip. And I also kind of always tap my hand down, right? Instead of like not touching the floor and having to like stop the weight in that momentum. Five, four, three. Does that feel any different when you don't set it down at all? Two, one. Good. Back through center. Feet down, knees down. Inhale, arms up. Get that full extension of your spine. And right elbow outside edge of left knee. I'm gonna work on it a little bit in basics tomorrow, but I had someone describe like the diaphragm is almost like this frisbee. And I kind of think of that like dropping my awareness to like my bottom ribs where my diaphragm is connected, and then kind of like throwing it back to the back corner of the room. Inhale, exhale. Release, shift forward, roll over your chin, take your weight at the top here. And step it back into plank. Yep, and then push your hips up and back into a downward facing dog. I don't know if you've ever had a wrist injury, right? But a lot of times they'll make you do your down dogs with like your thumbs fully facing forward. See how that kind of feels in your body, in your shoulders. And then here's our work. We're gonna come forward into plank. Yeah, bend your elbows, take a chaturanga, push into the right weight, do a renegade row with that left elbow, pulling it up, set it down, try not to twist in the hip, renegade row, right side, good, look forward, jump your feet forward. Okay, use core, wrap the weight at your shoulders, and do a shoulder press all the way up. Good. And then that's our work. Weight down, jump back, plank. You can step or jump. Yep. Inhale. Chaturanga, press back up. Renegade row. Left. Right. You look forward. You spring forward. And then rack the weights at the shoulders and press up. Okay. Three more. I like to inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Push down through right hand as you pull. Same side. And step or jump forward. Good. Rock and press. Yep. And then I'm going to be quiet for your last two, Ellie, so that you go at a pace. You could always like pick it up or slow it down, keeping your control. Good, and I'll meet you for the last one at the top. Good. Soft bend to the knees. Take the arms out wide, flat back. Release your weights all the way down. Fold in Uttanasana. Inhale. Exhale. Hands plant the top of your mat. Step back, plank pose. From plank, right foot outside edge of right hand. Pull the chest forward, dancing monkey. So you hop with your legs using core. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Getting to that place where your right foot is around the same one. Good. Drop the back knee down. Lift and curl your five right toes up. Roll to the pinky edge side of that right foot. Yep, you decide if you want to use your right palm to kind of push and widen that right femur bone open. And then reaching back to fold the back left leg in, adding the quadriceps stretch. Okay, so we're going to push the hips up a little. Do that posterior tuck until you actually can feel like you could engage your left hamstring, your left glute. Widen the right knee open a little bit more, pushing the pubic bone forward. See if you can actually, it doesn't look as deep, but see if you can go a little bit deeper into that quadricep hip flexor and then think, dragging your left hand back to open the heart like a cobra or up dog. Plant the palm, press back, downward facing dog. Good. Sitting bones turn up. And see if we can like enjoy, take some pleasure out of knowing that we're getting a little bit stronger, keep like taking care of our mobility. Left foot steps, outside edge of left hand. Okay. Yeah. And then as you look forward, start your dancing monkey, nice and light, hop stepping it out. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Left foot out, back knee down, lift the left toes, protect the ankle, roll, see if you can see completely the bottom of that left foot, and then maybe push that left femur bone away. And then once your chest rolls open into the twist, left arm reaches back. Grab a hold of that back right foot. And then hips up. Perfect. Cat pose. Lifting that right frontal hip point up until you feel the stretch. And then keeping that melt back in. We feel this constant trying to lift the pelvis up off the head of the femur bone, trying to stretch the rib forward. And then as you pull your right hand back, maybe even engaging the tricep, the back of that posterior deltoid, try to open a little more here. Inhale. And exhale, hand to the mat, press back. Downward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale, hands stay grounded at the top of your mat. Look forward and you jump forward. Yep, pick your hands up. So it's called a sprawl, hands up. Good. Plant the palms and jump back. Yep, always doing these at a pace here, Ellie, that you can like obviously you know, like can protect your low back. And you're gonna do five, four. Use your lower abdominals to zip the leg forward. Three, two. Okay, now when we get up here, dig your elbows against your inner knees. Hips up, hips down, Malasana. Up and down, dig into the heels. Hopefully starting to feel this a little bit up at the top of the hip creases. Chest up and five. Full range of motion. Four, three, two, one. Come all the way down. Hold in your Malasana. Press the knees into the elbows back out into the knees. Pull the spine deep into the center of the body. Inhale. Exhale. Plant the palms, step back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg lifts, three-legged down dog. Take your right knee, your right tricep. Let it slide down to your right wrist. Pull it over to your left wrist. Vacuum it back up and send the leg back. Inhale. Two more full rounds. Round in. How high can you lift up that right shin bone? Lower down, hover using the back left leg. Squeeze inner thighs, get that right knee to your right left wrist. Push back up and leg up and back. Inhale. One more. Forward tap. Slide down with control without losing the back leg. I like to think inner thighs help pull that across. And then sweep it back up. Good. Inhale, right leg up and back. This time, right knee on the floor behind your right wrist. Come up onto fingertips in pigeon pose. And then inhale, open. Bend elbows, melt down in and squeeze into that back hip. Perfect. Push into the floor, follow your breath. So remember the opening of the hands at the beginning of class in the folding in for two. One more. In. And exhale, lower. Lift back up, plant palm, press back. Downward facing dog. Repeating. So sometimes it's the second side when I know what's coming when I have resistance. Left leg up. Okay, thank you. I feel better because I'm sweating. Inhale, leg up. Exhale, tap. Get the little pause. Slide. I lose the back leg here. Keep that. Bring it across. And then I think it's like vacuum. It's coming way back up. Beautiful. Take it up and back. Inhale. Exhale, maybe a little higher every time. Hover. And then inner leg, help to pull it across. Push. Back up. Spread out through the toes. That's your inhale expanding. And then this is like kind of like that fist, pulling in, contracting. Knee slides down. Draw across, straighten the back leg, push up, and three-legged down dog. Left knee on the floor, take it nice and wide. Good. Pop the fingertips, roll the biceps forward. Like I glue my hands down here, Allie, but I like kind of turn imaginary dials in opposite directions. Using the floor, spin the shoulder blades onto your upper back, and then exhale, bow in. Inhale to lift. Exhale to lower. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Coming all the way back up. Plant palms, press back. Downward facing dog. You need it out through the mouth. Inhale. Expand that big frisbee and exhale. Walk your feet forward, top of your mat. I'm gonna grab my weight and let's turn to face one another. We're gonna rack the weights at the shoulders. And I think I'm just gonna start with my left leg. Okay, you're gonna take it out wide and you squat down. And so I like to kind of get my elbows, it just gives me like a good kind of touch point, elbows to knees. Press back up and step out in the opposite side. Okay, so it's core on the way down. Seeing if you can feel your glutes on the way up. I like to lift all 10 toes because I do have a tendency to pitch forward in my body. So I keep the weight back in the heels and I do try to keep my chest up as much as possible. If it's super easy because for you because of like the weight load, you could pulse a little bit at the bottom. You could come down and just do like a one, two pulse and then press back up. Stay connected to core, down and pulse, two, three, and back up. Okay, so we have five, four, good, three, two. And as you come through center, one. Okay, we're gonna keep that wide. Drop your weights down here, Allie. Heels in, toes out. Hover the weight, and then just come all the way up. Okay, bend the knees out wide. So it's a Romanian Sumo squat, exactly. Yep. So it's more, and you're doing it correctly, it's more of like the hip hinge. And what I notice here is that I always let my shoulder blade slide off my upper back. I want to have a good healing feel of extension in the spine. And then same with what we were doing with our hands in the King Cobra. Think that your feet are glued down, but you're trying to spin your inner heels forward. Okay, we're going to do five more, but then as you come down here, do that little pulse. Three, two, one, and then back up. Number four, flat back, knees wide. Two, three, four, back up. Inhale. Lower. Maybe make sure the weights are underneath your shoulders. I notice I always rest my weight on my thighs. I might keep them a little bit away. Last two. Yep. Good. Maybe not resting the weight on the thighs with all that time under tension. And then hinge. Two, three, four. Good. As you come up, step to the top of your mat. Roll the shoulder blades down your back. Okay. And then starting with your left foot, step it back into a reverse lunge and step forward. Good. And keep changing it out here. So the front leg, you actually want to try to like push your torso backwards. I tend to lean out over the front leg. I actually want to get to that place where I dig into my right heel and push my torso. Very good. Yep. And let's go. Five. Four. Yep. And because of your weights, if you ever want to get down there, do a little pause or a little hold pulse. Two. Back up to center and right leg back. Squeeze underneath to the midline as you come back up to center. Really good. Turn to face me. And this will be our last one here. Let's start with right leg. Right leg stuck behind in the curtsy squat, but then add the bicep curl. Good. Okay, so this is for outer hip and then inner thigh as you step to stand. Good. Core in. And then sometimes, Ellie, I try to kind of like balance for just a moment, right? Kind of setting it there and step down. Perfect. Five. Four. Three. Too. So I always used to see how like more cardio. I would see how fast I can do them. Sometimes when you slow down and really catch the weight, you feel it more. Good. Okay. Get rid of those. Take your booty band. Put it across like the upper thigh, and come out to center. And so it's actually really good. You know, like I mean, I kind of got the booty band kind of inspired by both of our kind of like hip low back stuff. Feeling that I always need more stability. So we're gonna lift the left leg out, but kind of use the right leg as that point of stability that you're trying to kind of like pull the right femur bone in as you do these fire hydrants. Okay. Probably the only thing I really look for here still is to make sure that my frisbee isn't like dropping down towards the floor. I'm pulling it up into the body, like lifting the front ribs. Staying stable there. And if you ever need more, right, you could hold at the top, you could pulse at the top. Five, four, want you to kind of burn out that inner thigh. Three, two, one. Good. Left knee down. Readjust. Maybe lift the gaze and continue. Right side up and out. Kind of same way when we started with those initial weights, resist on the way up and resist on the way down. Five, four, Three, two, you need any pulsing. One, good. Bring your knees back to center. Tuck your toes. Push your hips up and back, down dog. And I know that's like one of those really rubbery ones, so it might not feel too strong, but still get this feeling that your heels are pressing out. You're kind of widening your femur bones into the strap. You're trying to put some resistance onto it. And see if that helps you to get any more kind of like rotation through your outer hip. Inhale. Exhale, step your feet together, Ellie, and kind of like let that booty band just like slide, kind of help it off your upper thighs. Good. If you can step out of it, knees down to the mat. So the whole purpose of that was to kind of tire out those muscles as you step your left foot out to the side. I'm going to keep my right toe pointed as I hinge all the way back, turning my left toes up towards the ceiling, and then folding in here. Okay, so every single pose has a focal point. And what a focal point means is that is where energy draws into and expands out of. So could we expand our awareness to like the top of our head, the bottom of the left foot, even to those right toes? And like that fist, kind of imagine that we're pulling all the energy in to the center of our pelvis, like right in, like deep into the center of the hips. And then once you feel like even up through the right leg, that we actually kind of get compact, then what does it feel like to kind of stretch out from there? Like all that energy that you pulled in, let it stretch out. Inhale. Exhale. Using this if we're too slow down the breath. Come back up to center, knees together. Hopefully, you feel a little different between the left leg, right leg. Right leg goes out to the side. And as you hip hinge your left sitting bone all the way back to the left heel, make sure you rotate right leg and fold in. Right. And I mean, I think, you've experienced over your years and years of practicing where the yoga practice first changed me into being more flexible. But then my biggest learnings were learning how to actually pull in, get more stable. And can you pull in without like tightening the neck, hardening? And once I feel like I've really plugged the spine into the hip, both femur bones into the hip, then I try to like spread that out and forward so it's very integrated. Use your hands. Press your way back up to center. You can let that left foot slide in as your right leg comes forward to come to lie all the way down. Final one, knees into your chest. Interlace the hands behind the back of your head. First, I always lift up and I get up like up onto my bra strap, both shoulder blades up, right leg forward, and do your bicycle twist. Yeah. And I definitely press my elbow and knee together. So I get a little bit more of that inner thigh. That's the pause. Five, four, three, two, one. Left knee in. Grab that left shin bone here. Ali, as you lie all the way down, right leg can release. And then take a simple twist. What would it feel like if you had a booty band on here? And with both femur bones, you were pressing out. So, like, what happens is my bottom right leg rounds deeper into the floor. And instead of just pushing my left knee down, like I was always taught, what's it like to widen it up, feel more space through the sacrum, and then twist through that frisbee? Inhale. Exhale. Come back to center, knees in towards your chest. Interlace the hands behind the back of your head. And last one, come all the way up. Left elbow, right knee. Sometimes you can think shoulder and press and control that there. Both pulling the leg in and pushing it out. Good. Five, four, three, two, one. Right knee's in. Grab that right shin bone. Lower all the way down. Little squeeze through the back of the hip. And then twist. Good. With this feeling that you're actually widening the pelvis. Maybe as the eyes start to close down, remember the beginning of class, the opening and closing of the fist. Maybe feel now it's not just the hands, but maybe you could get that kind of entire body, like expanding as you inhale and drawing in as you exhale. One more. And then as you roll back onto your back, take as much space as you need as you open your arms, open your legs. You need a long exhale out through your mouth. You can take it there. And so there can be that resistance, but there's also that kind of, I don't know, even feeling of like pleasure, feeling just a little bit proud when you kind of overcome that resistance. Inhale and exhale. And take your time as you slowly make your way back up to find seated.
with your hands folded in front of your heart in the beginning of the new year. Like, is there something you wanted to start, right? That you feel the resistance to it? Kind of ask yourself, why am I trying to take on too much? Or am I actually not that interested in it? And then you find something that maybe you want to make a daily practice and you commit to it. Taking your thumbs to your third eye, bow forward to seal your practice. John, Siddhartha.